The Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild introduces you to a Hyrule that is truly seamless, where simply moving from one place to another begins to create what may be the adventure of a lifetime. And not only is this new world vast, but it feels alive. It teems with adventure. Throughout Link's quest, Hyrule will be a resource, an ally, an enemy, and always a place for discovery and wonder. This is easily one of the biggest experiences ever created by Nintendo. And today, you're going to get a close-up look. The portion of the game we're highlighting at E3, a wide-ranging plateau, may seem huge. In fact, no one here this week will be able to explore all of it. But even then, that plateau is only a tiny fraction of the full game map. We'll be devoting almost this full first day of Nintendo Treehouse Live coverage to just this one environment. Then, in the future, you'll learn more about the story, the characters, and the ways in which the boundaries of all previous Zelda titles are being broken. But in the end, full understanding and full immersion will only come when you experience it for yourself. However, before we show you this biggest adventure for Wii U and NX, we're going to show you the biggest new adventure coming up for Nintendo 3DS. As you've heard, there are two new core Pokemon titles on the way on November 18th, Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon. As always, you'll pick which new starter Pokemon to partner with. But which one to choose? Exactly what kind of battling awaits you? And what does the new Alola region have in store for players? Well, we figured there was no one better equipped to answer those questions than the two key developers of the game itself, producer Junichi Matsuda and director Shigeru Omori of Game Freak. So before we devote the rest of the day to The Legend of Zelda, I'm going to turn it over to the Treehouse team, along with Mr. Matsuda and Mr. Omori, to show you what it's like to start as a Pokemon trainer in the first ever live gameplay demonstration of Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon. So let's jump in. Take it away, Sam and Terry.
Thanks, Reggie. And thanks to everyone watching for tuning in and joining us for another Nintendo Treehouse Live at E3. We're really excited to get started. So as Reggie mentioned, I'm Sam from Nintendo. And joining me up here, I've got Terry from Nintendo.
Hey.
And my colleague David from TPCI. And we've also got our very special guests, Masuda-san and Omori-san from Game Freak, who are joining us to chat about Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon. Now, Pokemon fans already know that you guys have a very long history of working with the Pokemon franchise. But could you tell our viewers a little bit more about what you guys are doing specifically with Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon?
まあ、2人ともあのポケモンの開発にま関わってすごくあの歴史は長いんですけれども、今回のポケモンサンとポケモンムーンでのま役割について教えてもらえますか。はい。そうですね。あの今年ポケモンが20周年ということで、まここから先のポケモン未来に向けてのポケモンということで、私はあのプロデュースに徹して、今回シゲル・オモリがディレクターという新しい体制で取り組みました。
So this is the 20th anniversary of Pokemon, as I think many of you know, and when thinking about the future of Pokemon, I've decided that I would be the producer on this title, and also and pass over the director role over to Shigeru Omori here for Pokemon Sun and Moon.
今回ポケットモンスターサンムーンのディレクターをしました大森と申します。今回はディレクターとして開発全体に携わりました。
So I'm Shigeru Omori from Game Freak, and I was the director on this game, overseeing the entire development of it.
Well, thank you so much for joining us today. I know you brought some art assets that we can take a look at to introduce folks to the Pokemon Moon, Pokemon Sun collection. But first, we've actually got some video footage that you brought for us. So folks watching, if you sit tight, we're actually going to get that queued up for you so you can take a look. right, so there's a lot for us to talk about just from the footage there. The first thing I'd like to actually ask you is if you could tell us a little bit more about the background of why you went with Sun and Moon as the titles for these games.
まあ今の映像で結構話す内容というのが出てきたんですけれども、はい、まずはそうですね、Sun と Moon のまあタイトルについて、まあ、由来をちょっと教えてもらえますか。
はい、まあ、私たち の住んでいるこの地球っていうところには、まあ、生き物がたくさんいるわけですけども、まあ、その中で、まあ、その生き物に対してとても影響がある、まあ、そのコアとなっているものっていうのはやっぱり太陽と月っていうのは非常にこう大切なものだと思うんですね。で今回はその、まあ、生命を、まあ、よりこう魅力的に、見せていきたいっていう思いもあって、まあ、その一番影響のあるものSun to Moon っていうのをタイトルにしました。
So there's a variety of meanings behind the titles, but one of the main things is that, for example, for here on Earth, obviously, the sun really is the source of all life on this planet. And in the same way in the Pokemon world, it's also the source of life on the planet. And the moon also affects all of our lives here as well. And with this game, we really wanted to express this kind of feeling of a region really teeming with life. So we felt that Sun and Moon would be an appropriate title for the games.
I think especially thinking about these big elemental forces, sun and the moon, we also need to talk about those legendaries that are on the packaging, because I think folks are going to really want to hear a little bit more about what they can expect from those Pokemon.
まあ、そうです。太陽と、まあ、月の存在の多分、表しにもなってるんじゃないかなと思うんですけども、このかっこいい伝説のポケモンについて、話してもらえますか。
そうですね。サンに出てくる、ソルガレオっていうのは太陽の使者で、ムーンの方のルナーレは月の使者として伝えられているんですけども、まあ、今まで、以上に物語自体にかなり、関係してくる2匹になりますので、楽しみにしていてほしいなと思います。
So in the games, the legends say that Solgaleo and Lunala are the emissaries of the sun and the moon respectively. And these two legendary Pokemon actually, they kind of play a unique role. They tie into the story in a unique way that we really haven't done with pairs of legendary Pokemon before. So I think fans will be really excited about it.
I think there's a really interesting spiritual element that we get in these games. I won't talk about that too much yet because I know we're saving some surprises. But on the subject of legendaries, I know you recently had an event in Taiwan where you revealed some news about another legendary Pokemon folks remember from XY and what they might expect from that Pokemon in these games. We can maybe talk about that a little bit too.
ちょっと伝説ポケモンの話で、まあ、先日ちょっと台湾で、まあ、XY に登場した伝説ポケモンについてのニュースっていうのをちょっと発表されたと思うんですけども、それちょっと話してもらえますか。
そうですね。いよいよ 10% ジガルデとパーフェクトジガルデが、まあ、サンムーンに登場するというお知らせが、出ましたけども、まあ、今回この、まあ、ジガルデも活躍するっていうのが、まあ、ポイントかなと思います。
So, Zygarde, the Pokemon that...One of the legendary Pokemons that appeared in originally in Pokemon X and Y. It just recently showed off their the 10% form and complete form in the games. And these Pokemon will, or these forms will appear in Pokemon Sun and Moon kind of in a special way that I think people will be excited about.
They look so cool. And actually, here, since we're looking at a little bit of the Alola region in the background, so it's probably a good chance to talk maybe in a little bit more detail about the Alola region and what players can maybe expect there.
まあ、あと今回、まあ、冒険の、舞台となるそのアローラ地方について、まあ、これどんな地方なのかっていうのをちょっと教えてもらえますか。
そうですね。今回のアローラ地方なんですけども、他の陸地とつながっていない、地方となっています。なので、アローラ地方固有のポケモンが住んでいます。アローラ地方っていう名前なんですけども、名前の由来としては、命を育んで、まあ、命を育み生命力にあふれる大地という意味を込めてこの名前にしました。
So the Alola region, as you can see, it's made up of these four islands. It has a man-made island as well. But it's really this region that's just like a teeming with life. And that's actually behind the name of the region itself. We have this meaning of kind of region over, like a miraculous region overflowing with this life force that can support all this different life. And,
Yeah, I think it's really interesting since it's not connected to any of the other regions. You've got this really interesting area of isolation, and we're seeing all these Pokemon that nobody's ever run into before, and it's almost kind of feels like the Galapagos Islands where you've got this really interesting remote area where all these other creatures are popping up, and you've got new Pokemon in a really cool environment as well to explore.
陸地とつながってないので、他の大陸とつながってないので、こういろんな、変わった、まあ、生命が、たくさん登場するんじゃないかなというふうに思ってるんですけども、そうですね。
そうですね。期待しててください。
Yeah, I think people will be surprised. There's some cool things to see in there.
There are. I've been playing at work and I'm very excited to get a look at it.
会社でちょっと遊んでるんですけど、やっぱこう、楽しみにできるものは多いと思います。
And actually, since we're talking about new Pokemon, is there anything more that you can tell our viewers about the three starters that they'll be choosing from in this game?
今回の、まあ、最初のパートナーの、3体のポケモンなんですけれども、これに、この3体について教えてもらえますか？
そうですね、もうどの3体ももう可愛いんですけども、今回特に、動きについてすごく意識して作ってまして、まあバトル中だったりとか、まあいろんな時にこう動きが可愛くなるようなデザインとして作られています。
So of course they're all very cute, but one of the things they're really focused on with these three in particular is making their movements really cute when they're represented in the game. Like for example in battle and other parts in the game, you see them moving around and they're really cute, kind of make you want to reach out and touch them almost.
あとやっぱりこう世界中の人が見て、まあ、こう分かりやすい、デザインであったりとか、タイプのカラー、まあ、草タイプだったらグリーンが入っていたりとかっていうその分かりやすさっていうのをやっぱり最初の3匹は大事にしています。
And another thing we always pay attention to with or really focus on with the initial Pokemon that you choose for your partner is making them kind of universally relatable so people from around the world will be able to look at these Pokemon and relate with them very easily and also very easy to understand like for example the grass type Pokemon is going to be green obviously so being careful with the colors.
I think what folks have seen already from the animations that we've shown in a little bit of video footage we've been able to share they have a lot of personality. I actually picked Popplio because I'm a hardcore water starter fan. My first was a Squirtle and I've stuck with them. But I've been having a great time so far and I'm looking forward to seeing what other folks pick when they get into the starters as well.
最初ゼニガメ選んだので水タイプのこのアシマリを取って今回
いいですね。
どれもすごい個性的なので悩むんじゃないかなと思います。
It's interesting actually what you talked about with the design of the starter Pokemon. I think they also really fit nicely in with the kind of tropical climate and environment we've got. And I know that's something that you worked in with the design of the player characters as well this time around.
今回まあ南の国というような設定になってて、まあ、アニメのポケモンもすごくそれに合ってる感じだと思うんですけど、今回の主人公のデザインもそれを意識されている部分もありますか？
そうですね、やっぱり暖かい国っていうのを表現する、まあ、地方ですね、表現するためにかなり軽装にしています。
So yeah, obviously the region this time, the climate there is extremely warm, so we wanted to make sure that the characters, the designs were more lightly dressed than they, maybe other designs have in the past.
I think fans will notice the proportions are different, especially when we get into gameplay in a couple seconds here. They're going to see it's a little different how they're used to seeing their characters in the game.
またまあ、今回ちょっとこの後実機プレイを見せるんですけれども、ちょっとあれですね、頭身がちょっと変わったっていう話ですよね。
そうですね、よりこう没入感高めと思って頭身上がってますね、今回。
So yeah, we changed the proportions this time to be more realistic. We really wanted to kind of increase this sense of immersion, and I think you'll see that when we get into the game.
Yeah, and I don't know if I can talk about this yet, but sharp-eyed viewers probably noticed that both of those pieces of art, there was an interesting bracelet that the players were wearing. I don't know if we can, probably can't talk about that just yet.
あんまり話せないかもしれないですけど、すごい目の鋭い人は、腕輪みたいなものってつけてるんですけど。
ありました。ありました。
For later time, maybe we can talk about that. But I think we've probably kept folks in anticipation long enough. So Terry, you want to jump in and show some gameplay?
I'm excited for this.
待たせてるので、早速。
Here we go.
So I just want to mention, as we get into gameplay here, this game is still in development. So folks, everything you see here might not be exactly what you're going to see in the final release of the game, but I think we can give you a really good sense of what the game is going to look and feel like as we get started.
最初のもの。開発中のものですっていう。
そうですね、こんな早い段階で実はライブデモを行うのは初めてで、どんなポケモンが出るかっていうのもちょっと世界初公開のポケモンも登場するかもしれないんで、ちょっとドキドキしますね。
This is actually the first time for us to show a Pokemon game at this stage in development, kind of via live gameplay. So, not really sure exactly what we're going to encounter in this. We may see some all new Pokemon that haven't been revealed before.
Oh, keep my fingers crossed. That'd be really cool. Actually, as we get started here, Masuda-san, Nomori-san, can you tell us a little bit about the story and the background of what's going on right now in the game?
まあ今ここでちょっと主人公は何をしている場面になるんでしょうか。
そうですね、主人公はですね、アローラ地方に引っ越してきたばかりという設定になっています。で今回すでに、まあ、少し進めていまして、最初のポケモンはすでに、もらっています。で、今から、リリータウンというところでお祭りが開催されるのでそこに向かうところです。
So at this point in the game, it's a little bit slightly into it, but it's the player actually had just moved to the Alola region the other day and one day previous to where we are in the game, he received his first partner Pokemon for his adventure. And right now we're actually on the way to a neighboring town where there's a festival.
Oh.
And I think here, we can see what we were talking about earlier. Oh, you're just jumping into the low grass.
So as you can see in the Alola region, obviously it's not just new Pokemon that are unique to the Alola region, but from other regions you see Pokemon.
まあ今回あのトレーナーとポケモンっていうものもしっかり描きたいと思って、あのトレーナーが一緒にこうポケモンの後ろにいるっていうところを再現してますね。
And as you can probably see here in battle, you see the trainer is actually standing behind the Pokemon in the battle. So we really wanted to express this feeling of the trainer always being with his or her Pokemon.
Yeah, I'd love to talk about that in a little bit more detail here because I feel like there's so much that you've done with the way the battle looks in this game to make it feel really intense and really immersive. I was wondering if we could talk a little bit more about that with what you did with the lighting and the dynamic camera angles here.
やっぱこう没入感を高めるっていう話もちょっと出てきたんですけども、やっぱ今回こうすごい演出とか見た目が違ってて、光の表現とかもありますね。
そうですね。あのちょっと時間によって影が長くなったりとかっていうのも入ってたりしますね。
So yeah, there's some cool lighting effects that we're doing here where, for example, like a shadow, you see it's in the evening right now, so it's a bit longer, but depending on the time of day, the lighting will kind of affect the mood of the battle.
I think here Terry's kind of staying still for a second to let us see how the camera is moving around. And this is something that'll just happen for you if you're staying still in the battle for a moment. And you really get a good chance to get a look at these Pokemon and the area that you're in and the environment.
まあこうやってあの一回、まあ、テリー今止まってくれてるんですけれども、まあこうカメラの演出を見せたりとか、まあ結構やっぱこういう かっこいいカメラの演出があって、すごいこうバトルフィールドの全体を見渡せるような感じになってますね。
今回カメラもすごいダイナミックさっていうのを非常に意識して演出を入れていますね。
So yeah, there's definitely some cool. We try to make the camera feel really dynamic in the battles this time around.
And actually, as Terry gets started in the battle here, I was wondering if we could talk a little bit more about the different changes you've made to the battle interface. I know there's a lot here that's really interesting, which makes the game really accessible to new players. Maybe this is their first Pokemon game, but it's also, I think, really satisfying as someone who's played a lot of Pokemon games. It feels really good, the changes that you've made here.
結構あのまあベテランにもやっぱ初心者にも結構優しい感じのインターフェースにちょっとまあ今まで違う印象があるんですけども、どういう変更を加えたんでしょうか。
そうですね。まあ今回とても親切なというか説明がいろいろ入れています。例えばその、インフォメーションボタンがあるんですけども、そちらをタッチすると今その技がどんな技かというのを一目で分かるようになっています。
So for example, yeah, we really tried to focus on making it really accessible and easy to understand. You saw on the moves there, Terry just pressed the little I button or the icon that's on the move, and you can go into a detailed explanation of what that move actually does.
I think it's been so helpful. There are just so many Pokemon that you have to keep in mind now as you're battling. It's so nice to be able to pull it up, and if maybe you don't quite remember what something does, being able to just pop it up really fast there, it's like you don't have to use that information, but if maybe your memory is not as good as it used to be and you need it, it's so nice to be able to pull that up and take a look.
まあちょっとこの技はまあどういう効果があるんだっけみたいな、ちょっと忘れて
た。ああ、そうですね。できるようになって、大丈夫です。例えば今レディバの方をタッチしてもらいますと、今どんな状態かっていうのが分かるようになってます。
So actually you can see there's theYou can tap on the 2D Pokemon icon that's at the touch screen and see how its parameters actually just got changed because of the effect of a move.
今まで全部覚えてなきゃいけなかったんですけど、これで一目で分かるようになってます。
So as you just said, like a lot of things you had to keep in your head, you had to remember before, now visualized on the interface itself.
All right, let's see how this battle goes. Are you planning on trying to capture this?
I'm going to begin my quest to catch them all.
Okay, look.
You can do it, I think.
So just to bring up real quickly, for folks who maybe haven't played a Pokemon game before, battling Pokemon is really at the core of what the series is all about. You're going out into the world with your Pokemon, battling. Oh, this is the most stressful moment. Nice. Okay, so we're able to catch this Pokemon. But it's a really interesting game if you're interested in battle and strategy and collecting all these really interesting Pokemon that you meet. And Popplio leveled up. Good job. And it was nice there too, seeing how the level up change.
ちょっとあれですね、レベルアップの演出もちょっと変わりましたね。
そうですね。
Oh, and this is actually something that we should talk about as well. Can you tell our viewers a little bit more about what they're seeing on the upper screen?
これ今ちょっと図鑑に登録されてるんですけども、これちょっと違う感じがありますね。
そう比べてですね。今回図鑑の遊びとして、まあ埋めたくなるっていう要素をすごく書き立てるようにしました。で、あの白いモンスターボールなんですけども、実はあそこが空きスペースになっていて、例えばその捕まえたポケモンの、まあ、進化後か、それとももしかしたらペアとなるポケモンが出てくるかもしれないっていう。風に演出しています。いろいろこうどんなポケモンがいるんだろうって考えながら育てたり捕まえたりしてほしいなと思います。
So one of the things we wanted to do with the Pokedex this time was really encourage players to again really want to catch them all, really fill up the Pokedex. And one way we've done that, as you can see, there's the ladybug just got registered, but next to it is a white Pokeball icon. And what that does, that indicates there's an empty space, which means that either it has an evolution or maybe there's another Pokemon out there that kind of forms a pair with it. So that'll kind of encourage players to really want to fill up that empty space, go out and search and, you know, catch all different types of Pokemon and kind of complete their Pokedex.
Yes, especially exciting, I think, when you find one and there's lots of white Pokeballs and you're just like, oh, okay.
So it's got a lot of work to do. たくさん白いモンスターボールがあるとやっぱこう捕まえたくなりますね。
そうですね。さあ次は。
Who we got? Oh, nice! One of the new ones.
これは新ポケモンですね。ヤングースというポケモンです。いつもまあお腹を空かしていて、まあ、お腹が減っていくとこう怒りっぽくなっちゃうっていうポケモンらしいですね。
So as you can see, this is the new Pokemon called Young Goose. It's always hungry, so it's always getting hungry, and then so it's looking for food, but whenever it's hungry, it also gets very aggressive.
I love its face. It's so cute.
I like the color.
I feel kind of bad for it though. I feel like you just throw it a bag of chips or something and it'd be like, thank you.
Always hungry.
Always hungry.
Always hungry.
Oh, it's close.
いい感じですね。
Getting close there.
もう捕まるんじゃないですか。
You'll probably be able to catch this one.
We're on our way.
Oh,
good luck.
That's two down.
Nishi ですね。
Yeah, this is always like the most stressful seconds in any Pokemon player's life. And actually, this will give us a chance to maybe take a look at the Pokedex. So we've got a new Pokemon to check out. So we've got some interesting changes coming to the Pokedex in this game. Can you tell us a little bit more about what fans can expect from the new Pokedex?
まあ今回図鑑がちょっとあの変わった感じで新しくなってるんですけども、この、まあ今回の図鑑についてちょっともうちょっと話してもらえますか。
そうですね。今回ロトム図鑑というものがあります。このロトム図鑑ですけども、ポケモンを捕まえる情報をくれたりとか、まあ冒険で次どこに行けばいいんだろうっていうことを教えてくれたり、冒険を常にサポートしてくれる図鑑です。
So actually one of the new things in this game is that we have this item called the Rotom Pokedex, and Rotom kind of inhabits your Pokedex and actually helps you in your adventure. So it'll tell you information about Pokemon that you really want to catch, or give you tips about how to catch Pokemon, and also kind of guide you on your adventure where you should go next, for example. So it serves as a really cool supportive function.
今下画面が黒いんですけど、あそこにロトム図鑑が入ります。
So right here actually we're still really early in the game. We don't have the Rotom Pokedex, so the touchscreen is just black on the bottom, but you'll get it later.
And here, actually, this is a great chance. If we just like take a little quick circle around, we can show off not only the trainer's proportions, but also the movement is a little bit different than what folks who played previous Pokemon games have expected.
頭身が変わっただけではなくて、今ちょっと移動のなんていうのか、その見た目っていうか、ちょっと動き方も変わりました、ね。
はい、あの今回フリーに自由に動けるような仕組みにしてますね。
So yeah, you can move around. It's free, full analog movement this time in the game.
Oh, and we need to tell players what's going on here when they're seeing the shadow come in.
どういう意味ですかね。
まあ、今あそこのキャラクターがこうモンスターボールをこう投げてるんですけど、あれはこうポケモントレーナーですね。で、ポケモントレーナーの視線に引っかからないように、まあ、上下でこうその緊張感をこう表しています。
So you see that, lady over there, or the girl throwing a Pokeball up and down, and so she's a Pokemon trainer, and what she's obviously going to try and battle you, but what that kind of shadow that appears on the screen indicates is that there's a that she's going to challenge you to a battle, so it kind of increases this sense of tension of you're about to go into a battle, and indicates that to the player.
So I can either avoid her or actually battle her.
じゃあこうバトルするか、避けるかっていうのは、
I think we're going to battle her.
Yeah, like it feels like that moment where two people are like glaring at each other, ready to fight.
Pokemon battle ですね。
But it is really nice if you're in a position where maybe you're trying to get somewhere really quickly, or your Pokemon aren't in great shape right now, you don't want to fight, it's nice to have that second where you can avoid it before you just kind of stumble yourself into a battle.
そうですね、ポケモンの具合が良くない時とか先に急いでる時はもう避けられるっていう、
あ、そうですね。
Yeah, that's right.
I think that's what we can see here. We're seeing the other trainer as well. And it's really nice actually just to get such a good look at the Pokemon proportions alongside their trainers.
今回トレーナー、相手のトレーナーもバトルに出てるんですけど、はい、もうやっぱこうサイズ感、ポケモンのサイズ感っていうのが結構伝わりますね、
う
ん、
はい、そうですね、結構 そういうところはやっぱりこうトレーナーがいることによって表現できているっていうのが今回の新しいところですね。
Yeah, that's definitely one of the new things. I think by having the trainers in battle, like you mentioned, it really gives you that sense of scale.
And I think from the experience I've had at the office playing this game, it's really going to surprise people when they take a look at just how big and small certain Pokemon are when they're actually standing right next to them.
まあ結構多分今まで実感湧かなかった部分も多かったんですけど、まあ実際遊んでみてやっぱこう、あ、このポケモンこの大きさだったんだみたいなって思うところも多分多いんじゃないかなって。
あと、トレーナーごとにですね、いろいろこうモーションを工夫してまして、例えばボールの投げ方だったりとか、まあ、ポケモンに指示を出す仕草とか、まあ、そういったものが細やかに設定されています。
やられちゃったポーズとか、
ね。やられちゃった。
And with the trainers being represented in full 3D this time, they all have unique motions and reactions. For example, how they throw their Pokeball or their reaction when they lose, for example.
アイテム拾いましたね。
They just got an item there.
I think there might be some more folks we can battle up here. As we're walking around, I'm hoping folks who are watching or listening with the volume up so they can hear the music in this area. I found it's really great how it feels. It really fits in with the tropical environment.
視聴者の皆さんも多分、聞こえてると思うんですけど、結構音楽が素晴らしいですね。南の国にちょっと合った感じの。
I love how enthusiastic he looks.
All right, Oliver.
すごいやる気ですね、この子。
ヤングースですね。
That's another young goose, looks like.
And we can see as Terry's battling here, with how the battle interface is set up, it's really easy to just get super involved in the battle to whatever extent you want to be. You've got all this information at your fingertips. It's not that you have to look at it all, but it's so nice that if there's anything that you need to check on, you can do it so quickly, mm-hmm. and you still feel really immersed in the battle.
これやっぱそうですね、バトルのインターフェースでこういろんな情報を 今回覚えなくてもいいっていう話だったんですけども、はい、まあ、見たいときはもうタッチ一つでこうやっぱこう情報をすぐに出せるのがやっぱこう便利ですね。
あ、そうですね、やっぱりこうバトルをしていて、まあ、こいつどんな状態だったっけとか、まあ、そういったことがすぐこう情報に出せるということは初心者でも、まあ、この奥深いバトルに、まあ、とっつきやすくなるかなと入れました。
そうですね、本当にThere's a lot of depth to the battles, but you don't have, for example, beginners, for example, maybe they don't want to, or they won't remember a lot of these different status changes and whatnot, but you can really quickly check on the state and see how things have changed.
I'd say I love Young Goose's painting animation. Young Goose is so cute.
気絶の演出が今日可愛いですね。
何が出るというの
でしょうね。ああ、ちょっとスパッポケモン。
ツツケラですね。キツツキポケモンなんですけども、まあ、1秒にこう16連打して木を叩くと言われているポケモンですね。
So this is a pick a peck. It's called the wood poker. Or excuse me, the wood Pokemon. I can't even speak. But so the setting of this Pokemon is that it can actually peck 16 times in 1 second. So it's got very fast beak.
16回というのは特徴だよね。
16回というのは
16.
That's interesting. Yeah, watching its animation as it's got very bird-like movements as it's kind of twitching its head side to side. And I think that the level of detail that you guys have put into all the Pokemon animations in this game is really fantastic.
ポケモンそれぞれの動きとかすごい細やかに設定してるという話だったんですけど、結構わかりますね。これ鳥みたいな感じでしょう。
そうですね。
首を横に振ったりとか。
Oh no no Terry! Oh no!
まさかの。
Hopefully one of your new friends is ready to help us out.That's a good chance to mention, actually, we did find a Pokeball earlier as we were walking around, and you can find some good items to help you out along the way that can help you heal up your Pokemon. And...
まあ、この後、そうですね、
high risk.
ちゃんと傷薬とか持ってるので、まあ、バトルが終わったらちょっと回復できるんじゃないかな
と。ああ、捕まってよかった。
ドキドキしますね、これ。俺もちょっと終わっ
ちゃったよ。What's good, that's
High risk to catch them all. まあ
I'm not sure your ladybug got a level out of that, though.
まあ、これでレベルアップですね。レディバが。
Almost another one.
ゲームの醍醐味ですね。
This is definitely I think one of the things that really makes Pokemon a fun game. It's kind of like a sense of tension here.
So do we have anything we can give Popoyo to
I think it's time to go to the festival.
Oh, you're ready. Awesome.
祭りに向かいましょうか。
Oh no. We'll just run for this one.
All right.
ちょっとこれは一回逃げよう。あ、ヤングス。
あ、ヤングス出ましたね。
Are you going to heal up after this? Or?
Yeah. we'll get healed up.
We'll get healed up.
I think before we get to the festival, because that's... Yep. Not to give too much away, but there's... There's more fighting in your future.
More fighting. この先もバトルが待ってるので、
そうです。
回復した方がいいんじゃないかっていう。
So, actually, as we come into this area here, we're going to be meeting several different characters that our viewers maybe aren't familiar with. Would you mind just giving us a quick introduction to them as they appear?
ちょっと様々な、新しいキャラクター出てくると思うんですけども、それぞれちょっと紹介してもらってもいいですか？
はい、そうですね。今、リリータウンに到着したんですけども、このキャラクターがハラというキャラクターですね。最初に、まあ、ポケモンをくれるというキャラクターで、PV にも、まあ、登場しています。
So this is Hala. I think it's been revealed already in a video that we've released, but it's a really strong trainer on this island, and he's actually the guy who gives you your first partner Pokemon on your adventure.
すごい強いトレーナーですね。
A very strong trainer on this island.
この子はハウっていうキャラクターですね。まあ、ニャビーを今連れているんですけど、この後お祭りで一緒に戦います。
So this is how, and you're about to battle him actually, as part of this festival.
あと、クックイですね。ポケモン博士です。今回は、技の研究をしているという博士ですね。
And that's Professor Kukui right there in the white lab coat. He's a professor who specializes in researching Pokemon moves, so like their attacks and such.
Yeah, I think based on the fan response I've seen, he is quickly becoming the most dreamy. Professor, thank you for the fan.
今までの博士の中でちょっとイケメンという評判が。
あとリリエですね。ポケモンのトレーナーではないんですけども、今後も一緒に冒険するキャラクターです。
And that's Lily behind you there. She's the assistant of Professor Kukui, and she's not a Pokemon trainer, but she'll join you on your adventure throughout the story.
And sharp eye viewers may have noticed her bag is kind of interesting.
ちょっと彼女が持っている、まあ、バッグちょっと気になりますね。カバンの方は。
なんかありましたか今。
Was there something there? Yeah.
Yeah,
ちょっとね、さっき動いてたけどね。でもまだまだ言えない。
Gotta keep this secret right now, unfortunately.
動いてたの見ちゃった。
You saw a move. 見てください。
Well, I think it's time we go into the festival battle.
じゃあそろそろ祭りのバトルになりますか。
So I think it's going to be really interesting for fans of the series to see this battle and the space. The way that Pokemon and Pokemon battles are integrated into the culture in these islands is really interesting. And you get these amazing battle spaces where other folks are gathering around and watching you guys fight.
まあこのやっぱこう人間の社会にもやっぱポケモンとポケモンバトルそのものがこう何ですか社会の一部にあってすごい大切なものっていうのがすごく伝わりますね。やっぱこういうしっかりしたこうバトルアリーナみたいな感じもできてて。
そうですね。まあ今回このお祭りなんですけども、2人の旅立ちを、まあ、祝うというか、そういう儀式になっています。戦った後に、この2人は島を巡る冒険が始まるというストーリーになっています。
So in this particular festival actually, this is kind of a celebration or a way to kind of kick off both you and Hao's adventures to kind of travel across the island. So it's kind of a ritual in this society.
And folks may have noticed there was another thing we can't really talk about too much, but just to mention Tapu Koko.
Ah, so it's
worth paying attention to that name.
いろんな気になる単語
ですね。
今後に期待してください。
Please report more information. Can't really talk too much about it.
And so, how about a Pichu? Who looks adorable?
かわいいですね。
今度負けないように頑張ってください。
Don't lose this time, Derek.
Leave it to me.
任せてください。
And here we can see,
what he's done
checking different effects.
そうですね、パラメータが変わったかっていうのを今ちょっと確認してるん
ですね。敵の相手方も自分側も両方見えるんで、とても便利ですよね。
Yeah, you can see both your status changes as well as the opponent's status changes to really see what's going on in the battle.
So looking at this tropical environment, I'm really hoping that you guys were able to pull off some business trips. There's some nice tropical locations maybe. I mean, it's for research, it's work. just have to go.
今回まあ、南の国という設定なんですけど、やっぱこう研究目的でこういろんな素敵な場所に行けたんじゃないでしょうか。
あ、そうですね、まあ、まあ開発のスタッフでこう実際にハワイに行ってですね、いろいろなモチーフを見たり、デザインにも生かされたりしています。
は
い、
so yeah, we actually took a, as the staff, the development staff at Game Freak, we took a trips to Hawaii to really do some research, and we've definitely utilized that to kind of reflect it in the game. And
I should convince my boss that I need to do that to prep for this, to really get this segment. I really need to go to Hawaii.
今回の、このセグメントのためにやっぱこうハワイに行ってくればよかったですね。
Come on, Terry, show us what you got.
Oh, that's
one down. Nice.
一匹倒しましたね。
So we saw with the icons as the battle started. I think Hao has one more Pokemon to go.
Hao はあと、まあ、手持ちがあと一匹ですね。
はい。
Ooh, and a new skill, nice.
新しい技を覚え
た。Getting stronger.
There we see one of the other new starters.
これも。ヤビーなんですけども、一回実はもう見ているという設定になってまして、戦うとですね、一回見たことあるポケモンはどれが効果が抜群かっていうのが分かるようなインターフェースになっています。
So at this point in the story, you see Hao has Litten, which is another one of the first Pokemon that you can choose in your adventure. But you've actually encountered, you've battled against him and his Litten once in the story. And so once you've, in Pokemon Sun and Moon, once you've battled a Pokemon once, the next time you battle it, you'll get information on your move list about which moves are effective and which ones aren't.
あれですね、スーパーエフェクティブっていうの、効果抜群っていう。
そうですね、So you're just explaining that, you know, water gun is super effective. Yeah, what it means
Japanese. I think I'll stick with that one.
Yeah. 初心者でも分かりやすい風にしています。
So just coming back to make it all very easy to understand for even beginners of the games.
That really is so nice to have that information.
情報があるとやっぱ助かりますね。
I think especially when you're trying to catch more Pokemon.You're like, okay, I actually maybe don't want to be super effective right now. I need to kind of whittle this Pokemon down. So being able to remember maybe you want to use your weaker attacks sometimes just to kind of get them just to that point.
捕まえたい時とかもやっぱこう効果抜群じゃない方とかをあえて選びたい人があるので結構役に立ちますね、この情報。
Nice. Good job, man.
勝ちました。
I love what a good sport Hao is about losing too. He's just kind of rolling with it. It's all good. So I don't think we can go too much further in the gameplay because we're going to start giving away story elements that we don't want to show folks yet. But you did bring another video for us to take a look at that has a new gameplay mode that I don't think folks have seen before.
この先やっぱ実機プレイを進めるとまあ、ストーリーのネタバレ的なところも落ちてしまうことになるので、まあ、ここまでにして、ただもう一つちょっと映像をまあ、持ってきていただいて、
はい、
持ってきているという理解なんですけども、はい、初めて、今回初登場の、新しい新モードという、
そうですね、
理解です。
ポケモンはやっぱりコミュニケーションとツールとして今までこう対戦とか交換とかっていうのをやってきたんですけども、まあ、今回はさらにこう新しい形でのまあ、バトルっていうものが登場します。Battle Royale っていうものですね。
So with the Pokemon series, obviously, using it as a kind of a communication tool, facilitating that communication between players has always been one of the things we've really focused on with the game. So trading and battling between players, of course. This time, that's no different. We've got an all-new multiplayer battle mode, which we're calling the Battle Royale.
All right. Well, let's see if our crew can load that up for us, and we can check out the speed play.
そうです。
So as we get started here, can you tell us a little bit about what